was such a brilliant idea that I stole it. Well, let's get real here. Everything I have here is largely because I have a YouTube channel. Well, hello my beauties and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 44 from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And today I'm showing you some goodies that I bought specifically for YouTube. This was not my idea, actually, because I saw Annette from Annette's Makeup Corner do a video like this. I will link her channel and her video down below. And it was such a brilliant idea that I stole it. Well, not really, because she knows about it. I said so. A little while back, I did a video called Things That YouTube Made Me Buy. And that in that video, I spoke about products that other YouTubers made me want to get when they were already released, you know, so kind of like older stuff. What am I going to talk about today? I have gathered some things in front of me, and these are products that I bought specifically to review on YouTube. I have here a combination of stuff that I liked, but I also have some things that I may not have bought if it wasn't for the fact that I had a YouTube channel. Well, you know, let's get real here. Everything I have here is largely because I have a YouTube channel. But yeah, I have mostly eyeshadows, which may not be weird, but I also have some other stuff. So let me kind of start with the other stuff first, so I cannot forget. I have two different lippies that I bought specific. Well, let's say it differently, that I bought the entire range specifically to make a swatching video on my channel. And those were lippies from Catrice. Let's start with the oldest range, which is these. The Generation Matte with the black cap. The formula is really, really nice. So yeah, I did not mind that. When they were new in store, I bought one or two. No, I bought two of the shades that I liked the most. And I really liked the formula as well. And then I was like, I don't hear a lot of people talk about this, so maybe it is a good idea to get all 10, then do a lip swatch video and see how that goes. It is still one of my best watched videos. So yeah, I bought them regardless. However, the entire 10 colors I bought specifically to make a video. I don't have all 10 left because I gave some away that I just didn't use. I still have some, and I also have two backups of my favorite colors or a backup of two of my favorite colors because I thought they were being discontinued. So there's that. But yeah, the Generation Matte from Catrice. Then these are new in store. They just came to store this week as I am filming this. And today is the 13th. Oh, Friday the 13th. And I have a black kitty cat, so never mind. These just came to store a few days ago, and these are the new line, the new colors from Catrice. These are the Matte Pro Ink, and I have here the color 070 I Am Unique. I have it on today, and this range is a little bit more pink. And when I saw this range, I was like, yes, I knew that they were releasing new colors. But to be quite honest with you, they were maybe two or three shades that I really liked, because this range is a little bit more pink based. And it is not what I gravitate towards right at the moment. However, I currently have four. I'm getting the other six as well for a video. So yeah, formula is very, very nice as well though. Okay, let's go next to, before I forget, kind of two palettes that I decluttered. So let me check my list that I have here. Yeah, the Essence Salut Paris and Hello New York palettes. I saw the Essence Salut Paris first, and I liked the color story a lot because I like pinky rosy tones. However, it was a little bit too soft for me when it launched, but I bought it anyway. And I bought it because Essence is pretty big here, is also getting released more and more in the States, and videos that I do with Catrice and Essence products are doing pretty well on my channel. So yeah, so I bought the Salut Paris, and I wanted to test out the formula, and I liked the colors enough to buy it. So I used it, I made a video, it did great. I also bought the Hello New York then. That was not really my color scheme. So that one I think I bought more for my channel than the Salut Paris. if that makes any sense. I don't have them anymore because I just recently decluttered them. It's just that, yeah, they just get lost in my collection, and quality was really, really nice though. So the next thing that I bought to really review on my channel is the iHeart Revolution chocolate gift set, not from 2019, but the 2018 version. I saw it in store. It was a big heart. It contained 2 eyeshadow palettes, a face palette, and bronzer. I only have the bronzer left. I only have the bronzer here because the rest I kind of, yeah, I decluttered. And again, I did not hear a lot of people talking about that. I thought it would be very interesting for my channel, and that is the reason I bought it. Would I have bought the complete set otherwise? I don't think so. It's not that it is a bad quality. The colors were nice as well. It's just, again, I have a bigger collection. I did not use it. It gets lost. So let's kind of stay in Revolution then. Let's go to this one. The popcorn palette from iHeart Revolution. And that may surprise you, but when the avocado palette launched, I loved it on first glance on the internet. I loved the color story. I loved the whole aesthetic of it. I wanted it, so I ordered it. The quality was really nice. I loved the color story. And the video did very, very well on my channel as well. So when this one released, I was like, if I like the color story enough, I'm going to get it. And that's basically what happened. So this is the inside. Would I have bought this if my avocado video hadn't done so well? I don't know. I think so, but I'm not sure. I do really like this color story. I love this pop of blue, that light tealy blue. I love the fact that you have some purples in here, that you have some goldeny, neutrally tones in here. But yeah, the reason that I initially bought it is because the avocado palette did so well, and I like this color story enough. I am very happy that I bought it though, but yeah, that's not what this video is about, is it? Okay, let's next go to this one from Revolution, which is the Reloaded Blackout palette. And this is what she looks like. And I kind of need to clarify this. I bought these together. So 2 from Makeup Obsession and then this one. And the palette that I really wanted to get, regardless of the fact that I'm on YouTube, is this one, the Black is the New Black. This is what it looks like. This is the one that I really, really wanted. Then I saw that they also had this one. And I was like, I can kind of compare the two. Maybe that will be interesting. So I got this one. Quality is nice. It's not a bad palette at all. But I would not have bought this if I didn't want to do a video on it. And I hope that kind of makes sense. But yeah, the other palette that I got, and maybe I shouldn't have gotten, is this one. The Intoxicated with Love. I only bought this for the reds and these two to combine with the Black is the New Black. So this one is one that I would not have bought if I wasn't on YouTube. Yeah, it's the quality is very, very nice, but the color story is just not inspiring to me at all. It kind of survived my last declutter because I still want to do something more with it. And that is the reason that it stayed, because I have a YouTube channel. So if I did not have one, I would have not bought this one, and I wouldn't have decluttered it already. So yeah, there's that. This one though, I really, really want it. So technically it should not be in the video, but I kind of needed it to clarify, you know? Okay, let's go next to, well, BH Cosmetics, because this one, the Love Signs palette, I bought specifically for YouTube, or at least I had, that was the, no, I made the decision to buy this palette specifically because I was on YouTube. When they have had been sneak peeking and hyping up this palette so, so much that I was like, I don't care, I'm gonna need that palette, and if I'm lucky, I will be one of the first to have it. And I was, and my channel was very, very tiny then, but it did really, really well. So I was one of the first to have a video online with this one, and that's the Zodiac Love Signs palette. I also really love the color story. So when I saw the inside, I was, well, very excited because I love this color story as well. And I knew that I would be one of the first to have my hands on it. So yeah, that was a win-win. The formula is amazing. So yeah, I only did, I think, 3 looks with that. And then my first impression was a two-toned look. And I need to play with it more. Because it's just a very, very nice palette. But yeah, I bought this one to review. Then, these launched. The Zodiac mini palettes. And there is one that I specifically bought to review. And then the rest kind of followed after. So let me start with that one. The Zodiac Aquarius is one that I specifically bought because I have a channel. Why? Because the color story is not appealing to me at all. I am an Aquarius. My son is an Aquarius. So maybe I would have gotten it eventually just for that. But color story wise, no. This one I bought to review. And then I saw that the videos actually did surprisingly well. And I was planning on picking up all the mini palettes. But I kind of stopped halfway because these I bought because I liked the color stories. Okay, let's next go to, let's go to this one from Soda Makeup, the Create Yourself palette. I saw this come to stores here and I didn't need it. And I saw the palette and I thought it was cute, but I didn't need it. However, I have a YouTube channel. This was a new brand and I wanted to review it. That is the reason that I bought this palette. Otherwise, I think I would have left it alone because I have this color story a few times over. So yeah, I actually just got done filming multiple looks with this palette. I think it's up. I think, I have videos on all these palettes. So I will list the palettes that I mentioned today down in my description box. If you want to see videos, I will link some, but I cannot link them also. If you want to see videos on them, just search my channel and everything that I've done with them will pop up. Let's next go to the last drugstore that I have, and that is Catrice. I love Catrice makeup. I think that their quality is getting better and better. There are some core products in my collection that I use every single day that are from Catrice. And when this one and its sister, the Next Gen Nudes, launched, I was like, I know my Essence videos with the Essence palettes did really, really well. I wonder. And then I saw my friend Christine Kaak do some looks on Instagram with the Nudes palette. So the sister one to this one. And I was like, I'm gonna need that one as well. I'm gonna need to do a video on it. Then I saw both palettes side by side. And I actually grabbed this one instead of the other one. At least as I am filming this, I just grabbed this one. I did a first impression with it as of yet. And I do want to do multiple looks with this one as well. But yeah. It's not something that I thought I would buy anytime soon, color story wise. So yeah, I am very, very happy that I have it though, just saying. Okay, let's next go to Indie. And let's start with Blush Tribe. The Lila 2 I specifically bought for my channel to review. I love greens. Why did I say then that this one is specifically for my channel? Because the shimmers are too little. There are only 3 shimmers in here. And I prefer, especially with colorful palettes, to have more shimmers than just 3. So yeah, that's the way that I liked to do my makeup when this one released. I need to say it correctly. Because now I kind of don't give rat's ass. I can do, I love to do matte looks as well. Or just a shimmer on the lower lash line. Or just a shimmer in the inner corner, you know. Also, Blush Tribe is UK based. So everything that Blush Tribe releases, I have sooner than someone in the US. So yeah, that's also something, you know. It's kind of a who gets it up first. That's what she said. Let's go to this one next. This is from Certified Eternity Palette. And when I saw this released or sneak peeked, I was really, really interested because this is a color story that I really like. I kind of held off on buying it because I was like, I am not first anymore and I have so many palettes to get through, blah, blah, blah. Then she had a sale and I was like, wait, let me search first how many videos there are of this palette. And when I searched, then there were 3. So I was like, now I'm definitely going to buy it. This is the inside. You can do very soft, pretty looks. You can do more bold looks. It's a very nice palette. I created very, very cute looks with this. Yeah, it was kind of two birds with one stone. I like the color story and there were not a lot of videos on it. Then let's kind of end with palettes that I think if you are on YouTube, it is almost needed to get these. You know, it's Jeffree Star. And there is one palette specifically that I specifically bought because I was on YouTube. And I would not have bought I would not have gotten if I wasn't on YouTube. Yes, and that is the Blue Blood palette. My fortune with the Blue Blood palette and with the Bloodlust palette was that I had a kind of first pick, or let's say that a little bit differently. When Jeffree Star comes out with a palette, it is very hyped up. You know that your video will get a lot of views, especially if you are one of the first to have it up. When the Blue Blood launched, it launched globally. So here in the Netherlands, there is a site, themakeupspot.nl, that sells Jeffree Star but has next day delivery if you order before 8 o'clock at night. His palettes release here at 7 o'clock at night. So I had it next day. So with the Blue Blood, I was actually one of the first people to have up a first impression. But yeah, let me show you the inside. Maybe you see it, what it looks like. Oh. So this is what she looks like. It still kind of really is not it completely for me. I would not have bought this if I didn't have a YouTube channel. Just saying. Let's go to the Jawbreakers next. The Mini Breaker is not... Yeah, I'm mentioning it because I kind of need to give you context. The Mini Breaker from this launch is the one that I really wanted. Because I love the color story. This one though, the Big Jawbreaker... I loved it because it is just a very gorgeous color story, but I was also kind of on the fence about it. I ended up ordering it anyway, and unfortunately for me, I needed to get it through Beauty Bay, and Beauty Bay took a week. So yeah, I was not one of the first to have a video up with this. So that was kind of a... I am very happy that I have it, and it is kind of my staple Rainbow Brights palette. So yeah, would I have bought this if I was not on YouTube? Yes, I think I would have, but not on launch. I would have waited. Then the last one that I'm going to talk about is George. George. Oh, this is... Well, Jeffree's latest palette. Mine is called George, if you are new here, because I will love him and pet him and call him George. So yeah, let me show you George. Oh, let me get rid of the plastic thing. Let's put George in the shoulder. So here's George. And yeah, I kind of always do this because it's just handier for me because I'm scared that I break the palette. This one I also bought on launch because I have a YouTube channel. This was the same as with the Blue Blood palette. I ordered it from the Makeup Spot. I had it the next day. I was not the first because in this release he actually sent out PR as well. But I was one of the first non-PR people who had a video up with this. Yeah, I also did an ice swatch video with this one, and that one was such a huge success. I think it is my most watched video on my channel. So yeah, you kind of need to think a little bit outside of the box sometimes. This one was kind of twofold. First, I love purples. I love blue purples. Blurples, I learned, and I'm spreading the blurple word because I think it should be a word in the dictionary because I like the word. Anyway, I'm rambling. When I saw his release, I was like, it's a nice palette, but I'm missing depth. I'm missing that deep purple. And I also said that in a video. And then I got it and I was like, ooh. So I did buy it because I am on YouTube. I would have bought it, I think, anyway, but not at launch. So yeah. So guys, that was it for my things I bought because I have a YouTube channel and kind of my reasoning why. There's another video coming that is things I bought things I didn't buy because I have a YouTube channel. So yeah, if you want to see that one, make sure that you have hit the subscribe button and the bell so you will be notified when said video will go online. For now, guys, this was it. I'm going to sign off. If you are new, thank you so much for coming over and definitely check out the rest of my content. If you like what you see, just hit that subscribe button and then, as I said, the bell so you will be notified of my next upload. Yes, it is time that I stop filming and go about my day. Thank you so, so much for watching. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up. Before you leave, give me a comment down below as well because it helps me out tremendously. And I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening, and I will see you very, very soon in my next one. Bye, guys.